How does nicotine addiction work? Hi, this is Nastya Davos, and in this video you will learn what is nicotine, what are the symptoms of nicotine addiction, how nicotine makes you addicted, and how you can start breaking free. So stay tuned! Before we dive in, subscribe to this channel and hit the bell button so you can get notified when we release more videos that are going to help you understand your addiction better and quit for good. Okay, so first things first, what is nicotine? Nicotine is a natural pesticide. In other words, it protects plants from being eaten by insects. But although it occurs naturally, it doesn't mean it's good for the human body. Inside the human body, nicotine is a drug. It is a stimulant in small doses, sedative in larger doses, and poisonous in even larger doses. Now, a common question I get asked is, does nicotine cause cancer? And the jury is still out on that. We don't know for sure. Not that it would be in anyone's best interest to tell you if nicotine causes cancer, but anyway, nicotine is not considered a carcinogen at the moment, but there are studies that show that nicotine promotes the genesis of tumors and that it can create resistance in some chemotherapy agents. But we don't know for sure yet. What we do know for sure is that nicotine is addictive. Using nicotine in any form causes nicotine addiction, whether it's through cigarettes, through vaping, smokeless tobacco, nicotine gum. It causes addiction. Now, what are the signs of nicotine addiction? It's not wanting to or not being able to stop using the thing you're addicted to. It's planning your day around smoking or planning activities that allow smoking. And I'm gonna use smoking as an example because it is the most common form of nicotine addiction, okay? So, another symptom is not enjoying socializing with non-smokers as much as you do with other smokers, is enjoying the smell and taste of cigarettes, is experiencing mental and physical withdrawal symptoms when you try to stop, like experiencing cravings, mood changes, irritability, headaches, restlessness, or insomnia, to name a few. Now, if you want to know exactly what are the nicotine withdrawal symptoms, how long they last, and how to minimize them, check the link I added for you in the description. And if you are afraid of the nicotine withdrawal, you need to watch my video, Why Withdrawal is Good for You. Again, I added for you the link in the description. Now, back to the symptoms of nicotine addiction. Another symptom is continuing to smoke or use nicotine despite having health problems that would improve directly or indirectly if you stopped. And the biggest one is rationalizing your behavior and always finding a good reason to keep on smoking, vaping, or chewing. So these are the symptoms of nicotine addiction. Now, how does nicotine addiction work? When you take a puff, nicotine goes to your lungs, then it enters your bloodstream, and then it goes to your brain. And all this happens really quickly. It takes 10 seconds for nicotine to reach your brain. Then it creates a dopamine release, which causes the so-called nicotine buzz, and this is what makes it addictive. Now, how does this happen? When nicotine reaches the brain, it binds to the receptors of some of your brain cells. Think of these receptors as a lock and nicotine as a key, so they bind together. Now, these receptors are called nicotine receptors, not because they are meant to receive nicotine. There is no place in the human body that is meant to receive nicotine. These receptors are meant for acetylcholine, another neurotransmitter that's very important for cognitive function. But nicotine is so similar to this acetylcholine that it activates the receptors, and that's how addiction starts. So basically, nicotine is stealing the place of neurotransmitter acetylcholine, and with time your brain produces less and less acetylcholine that's bad for you. It creates long-term problems. So, when a nicotine receptor is activated, it releases neurotransmitters, and the neurotransmitter that plays the biggest role in addiction is dopamine. Dopamine is a very important neurotransmitter. It plays a role in movement, memory, attention, and feeling rewarded. And nicotine releases dopamine, and that makes you feel rewarded. And it reaches your brain so quickly that you get instant gratification. And of course, this reinforces the nicotine addiction. The thing is that dopamine makes you feel rewarded when doing certain things, so you can do more of those things. For example, it encourages us to repeat behaviors that make sure we survive. Our brain releases dopamine when we eat, drink water, or have sex, otherwise we would starve to death and the human species would go extinct. But this dopamine reward system can make harmful behaviors like smoking seem important too, although they're not. And that's how nicotine hijacks your brain, by making you believe you need it, just like you need food. But nicotine, it's not water, it's not food, and you don't need it to survive, of course not. But nicotine tricks your brain into thinking you need it. Because that's what addiction is. That's what addiction does. It makes us believe we can't live without the thing we're addicted to. But of course you can. The problem is that over time, your brain relies on nicotine to release its dopamine. So nicotine is holding your brain chemicals hostage in a way. And of course with time, the brain builds tolerance. So you need larger doses of nicotine before your brain releases any dopamine. And with time, you release no dopamine. You just need nicotine to feel normal. And that's how decades of smoking can change the physical structure of the brain. The good news is that your dopamine levels bounce back when you stop using nicotine completely. When you stop using nicotine, after 2 to 3 months, your brain starts regulating dopamine naturally and your brain starts releasing dopamine when you really feel happy and rewarded. So, that's how nicotine hijacks the brain, by releasing dopamine and by making your brain believe that using nicotine, smoking or vaping is a behavior worth repeating. Now another thing is that using nicotine becomes part of your daily life, because while your brain gets this dopamine hit, you're doing all sorts of activities, you're experiencing emotions, you're in different situations, so you associate those activities and those emotions with smoking, and later those activities and those emotions and those situations become triggers. Some examples of triggers are having a cup of coffee, a glass of wine, taking a break is a big one, feeling anxious or feeling happy even. For example, you drink your coffee, you smoke a cigarette, you feel rewarded. After a while, drinking coffee makes you crave this reward feeling, and how do you get it? You have to smoke a cigarette. Or you feel stress, you smoke, you feel rewarded. After a while, feeling stress, when you feel stress, you want to feel a bit better. How can you do that? You remember cigarettes. And these are these reward loops that remind you to get nicotine. Your brain reminds you to get the thing it thinks you need. Your brain reminds you to eat so you can survive. The same way your brain reminds you to smoke, because it thinks you need nicotine to survive. Not because you enjoy it, not because you have a self-sabotaging or self-destructive nature, and not because something bad will happen if you don't use nicotine. It's simply because your brain has outdated information. It doesn't know any better. And the thing is that when you stop using nicotine, when you stop feeding your body with nicotine, you are going to have cravings. But only because your brain thinks you need nicotine. But as long as you stay off of nicotine, as long as you stay away from nicotine, you're going to show your brain you're just fine without it. So what's going to happen is that your brain's expectations will change. It's going to stop reminding you to smoke, you're going to have fewer and fewer cravings, and your brain is going to start releasing dopamine when you're really happy, not when nicotine tells it to. Now, what if you just smoke less? What if you're a heavy or a regular smoker and you want to become a lighter smoker or an occasional smoker, or smoke once in a while, one cigarette when you're out with friends or having a drink? Now, if these thoughts are going through your mind, watch this next part carefully, because it's going to save you a lot of disappointment. So, can you ever become a lighter smoker? No, this is not how addiction works. The more you smoke, the more addicted you become. That's how addiction works. The more you smoke, the more nicotine receptors you create in your brain, which makes you want to smoke even more. And this process is called upregulation. And the thing is that how much the number of nicotine receptor increases, in other words, how much your capacity to smoke increases, this depends on your genes. Yes, if throughout your life you've been smoking 2 packs a day, then this means that your brain can create the number of nicotine receptors you need to smoke 2 packs a day. If throughout your life you've been smoking 70 cigarettes a day, then that means that your brain has the capacity to create the receptors needed so you can smoke 7 cigarettes a day. And if you have been smoking 1 cigarette every 5 days, then again, it's because your brain doesn't generate nicotine receptors to smoke more than that. So basically, your brain, your body, literally cannot handle it. So if you're a regular or a heavy smoker, you can never become an occasional smoker. It's just not gonna happen for you, and it's because of your genes. It's like me wanting to play professional basketball in the NBA. It's just not gonna happen. And it's the same with smoking. If you try to be an occasional smoker, all you're gonna achieve is think about smoking all the time. It's gonna consume your mental energy, and it's gonna leave you in a constant state of withdrawal and tension. And when you face a stressful situation, you're gonna go back to your old level of consumption, because that is your threshold. Now, the good thing is that it doesn't matter how much you smoke because of your genes. You can quit just as successfully, because as soon as you cut off nicotine, your additional receptors that you created throughout your life, they start to perish. And that's why cutting down helps some people a lot, because while they're cutting down, their nicotine receptors perish gradually, so this helps them. Now, word of caution. If you're cutting down, make sure you keep momentum and reach zero. Because what some people do is they go from 20 cigarettes a day to 5 a day, and they say, okay, 5 a day, smoking 5 a day is not that bad. But you need to go down to zero, because you can never become a 5 a day smoker. As soon as something stressful happens, you're gonna go back to your old habit of 20 a day. So that's why nicotine is addictive. Now, how do you break free? Listen. The only way to break the cycle of addiction is to stop using nicotine. Nicotine addiction is a mental and a physical addiction, but the physical addiction is not a strong addiction. 4 to 5 days after you stop using nicotine, almost all nicotine is out of your system. What makes you go back, what makes you relapse, what makes you struggle is the mental addiction. The mental addiction is how nicotine makes you feel and how much you believe you need it. It's all your triggers, your routines, and all your emotions that you have connected to this habit. So the best treatment for nicotine addiction is to stop using nicotine and to change how you think about nicotine, to show your brain that nothing happens when you don't smoke, and to reprogram your brain to not think of nicotine as essential to your survival. So if you want to overcome the mental addiction, make sure you get the foundational video of the CBQ method. The CBQ method is specifically designed to remove the desire for cigarettes and nicotine and change how you think about smoking and nicotine and break the habit. The CBQ method has helped thousands of smokers, and it's the same method I talk about in my TED talk. It is based on psychology, and it is drug-free and medication-free. None of those things. The CBQ method takes you through the mental and behavioral stages you need to go through so you can reprogram your brain to not think of nicotine as essential to your survival. So go get the video, the link is in the description. In this video, I show you what are the 4 stages of the CBQ method and how they work together to help you break free from addiction. I show you how to get started with each stage. I show you how you became addicted to nicotine and how you can go through the same process to break free and reverse the addiction. And in this video, you're gonna get a great overview of your journey, and it's gonna put you in a better state of mind. So go watch it now. And let me know in the comments, what's your experience with nicotine addiction? And if you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to this channel to get more videos like this. Thank you so much for being here. I will see you in the next video.